Good day YouTube and welcome to my 6th tutorial video on Dragon Bones Pro. Today I'll be working on the updated version, which is Dragon Bones Pro 5.2. I'll be doing a what's new or a new feature session on this tomorrow on Dragon Bones Pro, just to showcase that. What I'm talking about here today is animation. So we finally got to this point, but obviously after that we've got a few other ones, which is called miscellaneous tools and exporting and so forth. So I've created a new animation here already, which is a new animation here. Noting that you can delete these animations if you want to, and the new animation command is with it at animation button there. And once you select that, you can see that just applying new animation specifically based on your armature. So this was the default tab that we worked on with our default pose for all of our animations. Now, note that you can't change this during the animation process. If you do that, it's going to actually affect your animations a bit later. I'm just noting I'm switching there to the animation tab there in the top left of my drawing area. That if you change the armature a bit later after you've created animations, it's going to change the way that actually poses, or your character poses. So once you change that, or once you set it up, don't change it ever unless you intend to on a new specific animation that's blank. So to start off here on my animation itself, which is the new animation there, I'm just going to go ahead and recall this or rename this, and I call this Kisses, which is going to be nice. Now to start off then, we've got our default pose created, but we can see that on the timeline at the bottom here, nothing has been specified or no keyframes have been taken. In order for us to take that, there's a few things to take note of. First of all, is to select our animation, noting my bones has been hidden in the background. I've got quite a lot available there, and well, I should actually just move this one for the leaves away, one for the whip, because that's only specific to this animation. Once you select all of the items there, you can start off by taking a keyframe by hitting the K button or just selecting that command. Immediately you can see it tags onto that. So that's my default pose. I'm over going to make an animation here over 20 frames, which I've actually set here on the top right here of my timeliner. Frames per second is 20 frames, so this animation is going to be 1 second itself. I moved those and never took a shot of that or keyframe, just to keep it out of my animations. There we go, now it's away. Another thing to note there is next to our keyframe button, there is one that says auto key. If that is switched on and I move to, say for instance, 4 seconds, and I move a bone, that's the wrong way around, so I have to go back to the armature just to switch over my arm bends. Once you do that, you can see it will actually animate over those 4 frames. The movement of that arm to that point. That's quite nice. I could actually fix up this side as well. And while I'm doing this, I'm gonna go change the eyes specifically. And looking at that, we've got eyes normal. Additionally, well, that's on the wrong one, that's on my mouth, not my eyes. So I can switch off my eyes normal, and I'll have my squinted eyes in the background. As soon as that happens, we can see that on that keyframe those eyes will close, and that's obviously when the kissing is going to start. Additionally, what I'm going to do is I'm going to move this body down. Maybe I should start this leg off inside. I'm going to have to move that default position for these arms from the start, something like that, something like that. Oops, well, that doesn't look too good. Just change that out a little bit more. Sort of force it to follow a different path. There we go. And this body will sort of move slightly down. Just going to move this point up. As we animate those 4 seconds. We can see that it will animate that. Now this looks a bit fast. Obviously you can change the speed as well up and down. noting that you can choose your speed, and at 0.2 looks actually perfect. So I can go ahead and say, no, let's make this one time speed and use that key mark we added there and actually add it up to about 15 frames instead of just, there we go, instead of just 4 frames. Let's see how that works. And that looks a lot better already. Nothing to eyes. Probably never saw that change there. So that switches off there. Let me maybe switch that off a little bit earlier. Moving that keyframe out. You can see the eyes close as soon as she's about to kiss. Now, what I've added afterwards was 3 hearts there. You won't be able to see it because I switched it off. Just looking at the images, just switching it on with the little circle next to the heart name there. We can see I've added a few hearts in there. So going back to the animation, this has been set off at default. So once I look at this and I start switching them on, say for instance, see where that bone is, switch that on. On that frame now, 0, where my green bark was, it will be switched on. So I'm just going to move that out to about 16 frames. We can see moving it on, then it switches on. But I'm going to move this up to here, scale it down with my bone structure there, that yellow marker, switching it down. Let me zoom in a little bit more, or I can just change the scale for those to 0.5 for the X and, oh, not 0.05, sorry, for the X and the Y scale. That not work. 0.05. Move this out to about that point thing. Additionally, what I've added was a different mouth, so I can actually go look at that specifically. Switch that one off, switch that one on, and on that keyframe, that will become visible. Now, these hands here has to move a bit as well towards that location. And as soon as I move that on display, it looks a lot better. Although it's not visible yet. So I'm going to move to my last frame, the 20, with these arms outstretched. So arms outstretched and making a jump a little bit because of the excitement. And then additionally on that plot, on that frame, I want to move it out up there, noting that on my draw order that's behind, so I've got to go look at or find that heart specifically. Ah, this is small, that's all. Scale it up a little bit on the bone, something like that. That hit it out there. And let's see. Oh, that's a bit fast actually. Maybe I just need to change this a bit in. It's in. It's in. It's a lot better. And just as a quick animation, it's not a lot of details on it. But obviously, playing around with every frame, making a bit more than 1 second, maybe a 5 second animation, you can see that you can actually build a quite a nice one with all the time you've got available. So things I've spoken about here was obviously adding a new animation with the toggle there, switching from armature to animation with the keys there, renaming with right clicking and renaming the options there, talking about the frames per second by changing that physically. On default it's 24 seconds, but you can change it down to 20 or 10 seconds if you want to make a 10 frame animation per second, and obviously your auto key and your add keyframe. In the next video, we'll talk about other options, like for instance the onion skin and so forth, which is going to be the miscellaneous tools. So if you like this video, please like it, and if you want to see more, please subscribe.